Every day, cholera treatment centres receive close to 2,000 patients, as Haiti still lies prey to the cholera epidemic that broke out in October and which has so far killed more than 2,000 people. Médecins Sans Frontières remains very alert and very active. The organisation's teams have treated 62,000 people in 47 cholera treatment facilities across the country. The number of cases in the Artibonite region, where the disease first broke out, is decreasing. At the beginning of December, post-election violence in Port-au-Prince led to road blockades, which prevented trucks carrying safe water from reaching the city. This could explain the recent increase in the cholera cases in the capital.
We have a large proportion of the population who no longer had access to water for these days, and we've seen a significant increase in the number of cases reported of cholera, obviously, in Port-au-Prince in the past few days. And then the other changes in the south, where there really had been very few cases reported over the last 2 weeks, really, there have been an increase in the number of cases, and it has already spread also into the rural areas of the south, where you have very low population density, but we're having reports of high mortality in small villages. So it's going to be a challenge to be able to help those populations.
In the north, the number of cases has stabilized in the towns, but continues to rise in rural areas. The main challenge for the teams is logistics, as many places are difficult to reach, like here in Zapricot.
La difficulté, c'est qu'on est à 2 heures de route de Port-de-Paix, à peu près un quart d'heure de.
The problem is that it's a two-hour drive away from Port-de-Paix. We're also about a quarter of an hour from Saint-Louis de Nord. But there is a large river to cross, so the people sick with cholera have a hard time reaching the treatment centres. The situation was very serious, so we rapidly put up a tent, and today we've been able to start treating and settling patients inside the tent.
To improve access to care, Médecins Sans Frontières regularly sets up new cholera treatment facilities. Treating severe cases, setting up rehydration points, and distributing chlorinated water remain the priorities.